Okay, good day everyone. Today we will be discussing analysis of variance, or what we called ANOVA or F-test. Now, analysis of variance has two classifications. We do have one way and we have two way. Now, one way is also known as single factor. What is analysis of variance? Now, analysis of variance is the standard technique for quantifying and partitioning sample variance in experimental data. Now, remember, when we talk about experimental data, we are not assuming that we are talking about research design, but rather in the quantitative research, regardless whether you are using experimental or descriptive research design, experimental data that we are talking here is the manner on how we determine our participants as the source of our data collection. Okay? Now, when are we going to use analysis of variance? Now, analysis of variance is being used if we want to test whether or not the means of the three or more group samples are equal. Take note, we are going to use analysis of variance if there are three or more group samples. At least you have three group of samples. And since we are talking about one way or single factor analysis of variance, therefore, we only have one treatment factor. Now, in my presentation about illustrative example, I will be using modality of instruction or the method of instruction. Okay, now it also assumes that the samples coming from the three or more groups are drawn from a normally distributed populations with equal variance. That is the assumption. Okay, now, another thing. When we talk about analysis of variance is also the extension of the independent t-test or t-test independent, also known as two-sample t-test. Now, in my previous video presentation, t-test independent means or two-sample t-test is being used if and only if there are two independent groups. Now, why is it extension? Because if there are three, for example, there are three groups, group 1, 2, and 3, if you will be using t-test independent means, then you are going to have three different computations. The first one is group 1 and group 2 computation or comparison, group 1 and group 3, group 2 and group 3. Therefore, you do have three pairings for comparison. That's why analysis of variance is being used. Okay, now simple reminder. If you found out that the computed F-test value is greater than the critical value, therefore you have to apply the post-hoc analysis. Why do we have to apply post-hoc analysis? Since there is significant difference among groups, now you have to identify which among pairing of groups significant difference exists. And there are too many post-hoc analysis formula that you can use. We have the Tukey test, Sheffey, as my two most commonly used post-hoc analysis. There are also there are other post-hoc analysis formula that you can use in testing if there is significant difference exist. Okay? Now, in my presentation, we always have the organic formula And what is now the our organic formula? The organic formula here is F test is equal to MSB. This is the mean square between MSW or the mean square within. And if you are going to find the MSB, therefore you do have the sum of square between all over K minus 1. K is the number of category. Okay, for example, you do have modality of instruction. Now, in my presentation, I will be using 3 modalities. Therefore, my K will be 3. 3 minus 1. Then, sum of square within all over N minus K will be our formula for the mean square within. Now, N here as a capital N is the number of samples that we have. You have to add the number of participants for the first group, the second group, and third group minus the number of categories. Now, if you are going to find for the SS within, we do have this formula. And if you will be looking for the TSS, total sum squares, then you do have this formula. And for SS between, then here is the formula. But since we will not be using this organic formula and we will be using data analysis, then we will proceed in our illustrative example. Now, Bahagharing Lexie wants to know whether the method of teaching, which is the modality of instruction, affects learners' performance. Therefore, in teaching English, he randomly select and form 3 groups. One will be exposed using modular approach or modular instruction, the multimedia instruction, and traditional method. Then after the implementation or after the delivery of instruction, same questionnaire will be administered to determine the performance of the learners. Now, here is now our data. For the modular, we have 10 learners, and these are their scores for the multimedia and for traditional. And what then is our claim or our hypothesis? Our claim here is that there is no significant difference between the 3 methods of teaching at 0.05 level of significance. There is no. Then since the statement here is stated as equal, therefore, this is already the hypothesis. Okay, since this is now our claim that there is no significant difference as our null hypothesis, and our alternative hypothesis will be there is significant difference. And we will now be dealing with the computation. Okay, we are now here in our computation. Now, in this presentation, using the data analysis, I will be using column, and I will also be dealing with row and column. Now, first, we will be using column. Now, here are the scores of the 3 groups, 26, 27, 33, 28, 39, 42, 46, 28, 45, 25, 32, 35, 43, 33, 31, 24, 38, 36, 35, 23, 21, 30, 34, 33, 35, 38, 32, 32, 41, 31. Then we will now be using the data, then proceed to data analysis. Now, in data analysis, you do have the ANOVA single factor. There are also 2 other analysis of variance formula. We have the 2-factor with replication and without replication. Since we are just dealing with single factor, I will be using the single factor, then press OK. Now, since we are dealing with columns, then click the column and then highlight now the scores of the three groups. Remember, this is 0.05 level of significance. Then, enter. Now, here is our computation. Okay. Now, our F computed or the F test computed value is 0.8768. Then our critical value is 3.35413 or approximately 3.35. At what degree of freedom? 227. What is 2 and what is 27? 2 is the number of categories minus 1. Remember, we do have 3 modalities or we do have 3 methods of teaching. Therefore, 3 categories minus 1. We have 2. On the other hand, we do have 27. That is the number of participants. And we do have 30 participants. For the first group, 10. Second group, we have 10. Third group, we do have 10. Therefore, we do have 30. Minus how many categories? 3. Therefore, we do have 27. And since the computed value is lesser or lower than, therefore, we are going to accept the claim, accept the null hypothesis that there is no significant difference. There is no significant difference. Why? It's because the computed value is lower than the critical value. Meaning, regardless of the modality of instruction that you are going to use in teaching English, the performance of the learner will be the same. Okay? Now, as I mentioned earlier, we will also be using the row. Sometimes, during the selection of the, how are you going to encode the data or the scores? Now, you do have 2 options. It's either rows or columns. But here, if you will be using rows, then go with data, then data analysis, single factor, okay. Next, erase this one, select row, then highlight now the scores. Okay, now here is our computation. Now, as you can see, same computation arrived. 0.087677. Then the critical value is 3.35, degree of freedom 227. Okay, we are through with our example. Then we proceed in our application. Now, here is our application. We have same modalities of instruction, but this time we have social studies as our main subject area of discussion. Then, 40 learners were divided into 3 groups. And then, these 40 learners, 13 were selected and exposed using online instruction. 12 were exposed using distance learning with modules. And 15 combined online instruction with modules. Now, this is now the scores. Okay, let's try to answer this. Okay, we are here now in our Excel. Now, since the scores were encoded using rows, now, we will be using data analysis under ANOVA single factor, okay? Then you have to click rows. Why? because the data were encoded in rows. We have the first group, the second group, and the third group. Okay, next, we already have the rows, then highlight. As you observe, the sample size among three groups differs. For the first group, we do have 12. For the first group, we do have 13. The second group, we do have 12. The third group, we do have 15. 13, 12, 15. Then, click OK. Now, we have 13, 12, 15. And then, here is our computed value. 0.74, approximately. 0.74. And then, for the critical, at 237, that our degree of freedom is 237, and our critical value is 3.25. Therefore, same thing, the computed is lower than the critical, therefore, accept the null hypothesis. Okay? That there is no significant difference among the three modalities of instruction in teaching social studies subject. Okay, as for challenge is concerned, you can try to perform using the different way of computing the F-test using columns. And before I end my presentation, if you have queries, if you do have questions on how data analysis works, then free to follow me in my social accounts. And